English medium school. Welcome to English class. How are you? Hope that you are all doing well. We teachers are very eagerly waiting for the school to open and we will see. We have to continue the lesson now. We are dealing with lesson 5, Summer with Granny. We saw that Aradha visited her granny. She gifted a painting to her granny. Granny, who was waiting by the doorside, promised a colorful wig to Radha. Colorful means the whole week they are going to do different activities. Let us see what are those activities. Keep ready your pencil and an eraser to underline the hard words and write the meanings. On Sunday, the week starts with a Sunday. On Sunday, by the violet flowers, we sit. Sunday, they are going to a garden where the garden is famous for its violet flowers. Madai parayile kakapu, ningalkariyo. Madai parayile kakapu vasantham viriyarundu. Appa aarumudran kakapu kalam. Yes, same way. There is a place nearby Granny's house where it's an open space famous for the violet flowers. On Sunday, by the violet flowers we sit. They go and sit on the violet flowers garden-like area. On Monday, a long indigo scarf they knit. See the last two words of this? Two lines. Sit, knit. What are they? Rhyming words. Yes. On Sunday, by the violet flowers we sit. On Monday, a long indigo scarf we knit. Knit means it is not stitching but joining threads and making a cloth, woolen cloth. It is called a knit. It is like weaving. It is not stitching using needle and thread, but using a particular machine, a separate, a special machine, they do weaving, joining the threads together and making a cloth itself. Yes, our sweaters are made so. It's easy for you to understand that. So what they are going to make on Monday? They are going to knit, weave an indigo color scarf. Indigo is a color. Yes, we can see it in the vidyor, I mean rainbow. The second color is indigo. Vidyor, violet, indigo, blue, green. Yes, that order. After violet comes indigo. On Tuesday, we dip our feet in blue water, so clean. On Tuesday, they might... Where is the water in blue color? Is it in the stream? Spring? No. Water is blue. In the sea. So maybe Tuesday they are going to the beach to put their legs in the blue waters. Dip means put in water. Put in water. On Tuesday we dip our feet in blue waters. So clean. On Wednesday we walk under pine trees. So green. Again rhyming words. Clean, green. On Wednesday they are going to walk under the pine trees. The picture is here. See how beautiful it is. They are going to walk under the pine trees. On Thursday, I ride Chinar by the yellow mustard fields. In the yellow mustard fields, they go for a walk. I mean, Radha will ride Chinar, the pony, through the mustard fields. When you go out of Kerala, we can see through from the train, if you look outside, you can see some mustard fields in Tamil Nadu, Andhra, Karnataka. Such areas you can see mustard fields. Large area will be covered by yellow flowers like sunflower and all. Mustard fields are also seen at such places. They look awesome. So on Thursday, Radha is going to ride Chinar, the pony, through in the mustard fields, through the mustard fields. On Friday, we see the orange sun set behind the hills. So Friday they are going to see the sunset. What's the color of the sun when it is coming to the setting time? It's somewhat orange red. Yes, and on Saturday we try red chilies on the terrace. Underline the word terrace. Terrace. So a week is over, having different activities, varieties of programs. If you read these colorful words together, it indicates a rainbow. What was the promise of the grandmother? Grandmother said that the coming week will be as colorful as a rainbow. It is the exciting thing happened. Each day they had a different program. Radha was excited, thrilled, and she enjoyed a lot. She felt the whole week like a rainbow. Is there anybody who doesn't like rainbow? It was as beautiful as exciting as thrilling as a rainbow. It is Sunday again and time to go back home. My dear Radha, I shall miss you. Once you get on the train, Grandma was very sad. She was so emotional. She said, my dear Radha, I'm going to miss you once you get on the train. Once you step out of the house, I'm going to miss you. I'm going to feel bad without you. Promise me that next summer we shall meet again. That is what the grandmother wants, a word from Radha that they are going to visit Granny again in the next summer holidays. Dear Granny, what a colorful week we have spent. I shall never forget this summer holiday with you. Radha is also very emotional. She also does not want to go back home. Back home, the school will reopen, studies goes on. She does not want that, but she wants to spend with Granny, celebrating the weekends, celebrating the holidays. Those days were so beautiful, so lovely. That's why Radha does not want to go home. She says, Granny, you gave me so wonderful days. I will never forget the beautiful days spent with you. I'm waiting for the next summer vacation. I shall never forget. That means I will never forget. I'm not going to forget it ever. And let us read the textbook. Put your finger and read. Now, let us do the exercises, page number 41, exercise A, tick the correct answers. Do this and try to write the think and answer also. We will discuss it during the online session. And let us stop there, having this today. We'll continue the grammar exercises in the next class. Till then, bye-bye.